Careful, Mary. Us Brits can't get enough of the Costas.
We love Spain!
What more did you want?
Here on the Costa Blanca.
Nice moves, ladies. More and more of us are leaving the cold and grey of the UK for the Costa del Sunshine.
This is when it gets fun.
Living the dream can be hard graft.
I'll get the heavy ones done.
Inside.
Yay!
Service, Jamaica!
But Costa living can be worth its weight in gold.
Who's green for ice?
That's why there will always be
blue skies,
two-for-one cocktails,
those double puggies,
bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Today on the Costas, something spooky this way comes.
That's rubbish.
It's meant to look like you.
As Halloween fever takes hold. There's a nasty surprise for Matt at the honey farm.
One of them is either swarming or being robbed.
Oh, really? Oh, no.
As his new business is overrun with thieves.
There's a bit of a call of emergency.
And
503-53.
Bingo. Eyes down at Clark and Karen's for their very first Halloween bingo.
One house call. Give all a check out.
Nearly 3 million Brits visit the southernmost region of Spain, Andalusia, every year. It's also a great place for expats to settle. Just ask Wayne Ward.
Everything here is great and the lifestyle's easy.
Wayne and wife Lisa swapped Morecambe for the Med 7 years ago.
I'm just going to make up one of my specialities. I make a special fried rice. So I just thought if I just get something nice and light, that should be good. That should just keep us going until we have the food later on with the Halloween party.
Since moving to the Costa, Halloween has become Wayne's absolute favourite time of the year.
Halloween here is fantastic. The first time I came here and did Halloween, we dressed up and it was just also so much fun. So it's like one of the highlights of my year today. I can't wait. I'm like a child.
Wayne is the life and soul of any party and loves entertaining his circle of friends on the Costas. And tonight they're all invited to Wayne and Lisa's very first Halloween party.
The Spanish are really big on Halloween. Yeah, they're probably bigger than what it is in England, I'm thinking. We've got loads to do and not a lot of time to fit it in, so Lisa's in charge of the coffee.
I'm in charge of the coffee and the chicken.
And I've got a rice cooker, which is brilliant.
Oh.
Oh, press it.
Don't.
You tripped the electric.
I haven't tripped the electric. That was your fault.
Yeah.
You told me to make the coffee.
The easiest thing to do is to blame Wayne.
You might want to get that looked at, Wayne. But while the bird's cooking, don't worry, not Jimmy the Budgie. You've got a party to plan.
Just need to figure out what we're going to put inside the box for the party tricks. Because we've got kids coming as well, I thought it'd be fun for them if we just put, like together a box with some weird bits in it, and they can, like, put their hand in and we can see what they are, like maybe eyeballs or someone's brains or something like that.
Not allowed to scare the children this year.
Ooh, well, that's me having nightmares tonight. And it wouldn't be a spooky party without a costume.
I usually go out as a vampire, so and I like being a vampire. That's why I've never changed it. But I've repaired it every year and it's lasted fucking.
Sounds a bit long in the fang, Wayne. This couple's friends are all up for a party, but for his very first turn as Halloween host, Wayne knows he'll have to go all out to impress.
I invited about 10, but I know that one's pulled out already, so I'm thinking 8 of my people. I was singing in one of my show bars down here, and I was singing Happy Birthday to a guy. I just invited them, Paul, and his family and his friends. So they made up the numbers. There's going to be 23 of us.
Yeah,
it's going to be good fun.
Wayne's aiming to cement his new friendship with Paul and his family tonight.
I'm not in full now.
If he's going to throw a party to remember for his mates, this spooky party game needs to deliver.
Let's go and get the shopping.
Mm-hmm.
Let's hope the shops are fully stocked with eyeballs and brains.
Yeah.
Benidorm really does have something for everyone.
We love Benidorm!
Well, thanks, Debbie and Lynn. That's what brings thousands of us Brits back year after year on holiday.
Sixth time, baby.
Yeah, sixth time. We love it. Love it.
There's the Strip with its famous nightlife.
The nightlife here is amazing. It is the best nightlife I've
ever been to.
The beach, with over 3 miles of shoreline to enjoy.
It's absolutely immaculate. The sand is beautiful, it's like flour.
Then there's the old town with its narrow streets, boutiques, restaurants and all manner of bars to suit all tastes.
We love Benidorm, we love Benidorm, yeah.
I've already booked to come back.
But as publican Clark Bowie knows, as brilliant as Benidorm is, it's blooming hard work running a business here, let alone two.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm good, Clark. How about you?
Got such a busy day ahead of us.
Aberdonian Clark moved to the Costa Blanca with his wife, Karen, in 2017.
We get asked this question all the time, why did we come here? Well, Aberdeen's, the sky's grey, the buildings are grey, the people look grey, and it rains most days. So we've been coming to Benidorm for about 27 years, off and on, two, three, four times a year, but we're always going to move here.
And with not one, but two venues to run, a bar and a restaurant, life here in Benny is no holiday for Clark and Karen.
We've been doing 15-hour days, we're really tired. I need to get the bar open, we've got this event tonight.
Recently, Clark and Karen's bar moved into larger premises.
This is a new bar, it's got a lot more character, everything's on the same level. We've decorated for tonight, we've got our spooky stuff up. We're all rock and roll and ready to go.
And tonight, they're banking on a full house with their new bigger bar hosting its very first Halloween theme night.
We've got these blood cocktails, so you can fill your energy up if you're a vampire.
And nothing says spooky like bingo.
Tonight, we're focusing on Halloween. We've got to do a bingo night, a prize bingo night.
They've splashed out on a fancy new automated bingo caller. And tonight is its maiden voyage. What could possibly go wrong?
One of my staff members has messaged me and says he's had an accident in his flat and now he's away to the hospital. So I'm now one member of staff down that I was really, really relying on tonight because he's our aficionado in the cocktails. I'm good at the cocktails. It looks like I'm going to have to work behind the bar as well tonight.
Oops, that's what could go wrong. Sorry, Clark.
My stress levels have went through the roof. I'll have to get back to the bar, tell Karen that we're one down, and then we'll figure out how we're gonna function tonight.
Oh, dear. Clark's evening could be a real Halloween nightmare. Coming up, in search of fuel, Matt's going green. Well, brown.
We found some fresh boar dung for the bee smoker. It's the best stuff.
And Clark picks his battles wisely.
Get out my way.
Okay, okay, okay. My wife's maybe short and starch average is violent in nature.
I'm not. I'm a nice lady.
What else could we use that resembles like a body part?
In Torremolinos, Wayne and Lisa are preparing to put on a Halloween party to remember.
They'll do. Their eyes. I can eat a couple of those as well. So we'll get a cauliflower and we can put some honey on, so that's like a brain with brain stuff on it. I'm not saying it because I live here, but Halloween is 1,000,000% better here, definitely, without a doubt.
As it's their first time hosting at Halloween, Wayne's out to impress with a gruesome party game.
Stuck loads of honey inside there. You could say that as a body, inside the body parts.
Yeah.
Ugh. Yeah, get that. Did you want to use these as a couple of fingers?
Yeah. Big fingers.
Rawr. We've got inside the body, eyes, fingers, cauliflower for the brain. That was really good. And I have to say, that's a bargain. It costs like €4.
Gruesome body parts, fruit and veg to you and me, secured. Next job is the party pumpkins.
So you're gonna make my face on there. I'm gonna make you on here. So let's see.
All right, yeah.
You do the best one. I don't even know what to do. Never have carved a pumpkin in my life ever. We're too hard. Ta-da!
Looks like Lisa's working through a few things with her pumpkin.
What?
It's very stylish.
Ta-da!
Okay, should we have a pumpkin off?
Yeah. Ta-da!
Oh. That's rubbish.
It's meant to look like you.
Uncanny.
Oh, my God. You chopped half of its head off. I'm 100% certain that this is the winner.
Not yet, Wayne. Everyone knows the real test is how they look in the dark.
All right, shut that door, then.
Thank you, Larry Grayson.
Oh, here we go. Get the lid on.
Yeah.
I win.
But before Wayne can celebrate his self-declared win, he's got an appointment with his laptop.
If I'm doing something in the night time, like a party, I know that I've got to, like, do some work in the day because I've got to get paid at the end of the week.
Wayne's a seasoned musical performer by night, but by day, he runs a remote IT support business from home.
I'm hoping that once I've done this one, then I'm going to get the one for the main company, which is a massive enterprise. So I'm putting out as much effort as I can into this just to get it 100%.
If you put the same effort into tonight's party, you'll be on to a winner.
This is my dragon fruit. It's not doing so well.
Down the coast, near Manilva, someone else is just gearing up for work.
Today we're off to the new bee land. We're going to check on the hives.
Beekeeper Matt from Hampshire came out to Spain in his early 20s and has now lived here for 30 years.
12 years ago, I started getting into bees, keeping bees and dealing with honey is a passion of mine. I absolutely love it.
Hey, all right, mate? How are you?
Hello, mate. All right?
All good.
Good.
All ready?
Yeah, well, I've just put kettle on.
Cup of tea.
Coffee for me, black. Today, Matt and his business partner, Peter, are off to check on their 8 hives. But first, Matt's other passion.
I'm such a big tea drinker, and it's the only thing I drink. I only drink tea, nothing else. So I have a big, huge cup, and it's nearly a litre. I have probably 5 litres of tea a day.
I bet you're buzzing.
Oh, it's a good cup of tea.
Previously, Matt worked for a large-scale honey farm, managing over 100 hives, but now he's building a honey empire of his very own.
Should we go and see if we can get this spinner fixed?
Yes.
Working?
Yes.
OK.
Recently, Matt and Peter took a gamble and bought a plot of land in the mountains, and just 2 weeks ago moved their hives up to their new location.
This is our honey spinner. So we have 8 hives. In the winter, there's about 30,000, 40,000 bees in each hive. In the summer, it gets up to about 60,000 to 80,000. There's a lot of bees.
Today, the boys are banking on collecting their very first harvest of honey since moving to the mountains. It's cost around €500 to set up the 8 hives, so Matt's hoping this first visit since the move will deliver a bumper crop of honey to take the sting out of that investment.
Good, that's that. Basically, it spins the frames around so fast that centrifugal force throws the honey out to the edges of the bucket where it goes down and collects in the bottom.
Actual science, I love it. But without a handle, there'll be no spinning to collect the honey from the frames. So Peter's brought an old handle from a spinner to see if they can make do and mend.
I've always been good with my hands. I love fixing things. That was good.
And it hasn't cost you a penny. Job done.
I'm hoping we will get at least 30, 40 kilos of honey out of them today.
That's enough for 80 jars. That should sell for around €6 each, covering all their setup costs. So, if the bees have settled in well to their new surroundings, today should get their business flying.
I get stung every time I go to the bees through my suit. Now, if you wear clothing under your suit, they can't sting you because that clothing gives that just millimetre more gap and the stinger can't reach you. But I hate getting hot and sweaty, so I always go without my shirt, so I always get stung. I've got all the bee gear there. I've got my food, the tea.
Can't forget the tea. That'd be a disaster.
So we fix the spinner, and all we can do is take it out there and try it and just hope it works.
He's hoping it's going to be a sweet day.
Look, we got to kissy kissy camels. I did my first tour to Tangiers, my first tour abroad, actually catching a ferry and going to another country. And during that tour, we got to meet the camels. Well, the camel, not this camel, but one of the other camels was named Ronaldo by one of my customers who's an absolutely Manchester United fanatic. This is just camel. The positive feedback I got
back was phenomenal, to the point that I'm running it again. And it will probably end up being a regular tour.
Hello, darling.
Oh, hi.
That's what you're doing.
Oh,
I'm smoking.
For tonight.
In Benidorm, publican Clark has popped in to see wife Karen at the couple's second business, a restaurant serving traditional British grub. But he's not bearing the best of news.
Oh, just had a message from Nate. He's not got to be there tonight.
Oh, yeah, because he's broke his foot or something.
So you can't.
Oh, well, I've seen him earlier, right? And he said he'd hurt it and something snapped.
Yeah.
But he wasn't very sure.
For his Halloween-themed bingo night, Clark's hoping for a full bar, but with his resident cocktail maker off sick, he's going to struggle.
We've got maybe 5-6 different cocktails on tonight, so I'm going to have to dive behind the bar, make these cocktails, dive back and do the bingo, and if nothing else, it's going to make my life a lot more busier tonight.
How are you doing the bingo? You're just pushing a button and
It shouts for me, but...
Well, I can push the button.
Well, I'll show you, I can show you what to do, because you've got to be able to stop it when somebody shouts, housey, housey.
OK.
And then I can just jump behind the bar.
Karen to the rescue, even though she's a novice bingo caller.
No, I prefer playing it.
I prefer taking her money. She's a good winner, but hopefully she was going to lose tonight, so we were actually good. Somebody else might have won.
I prefer winning.
Oh, me too, Karen. Me too.
If anybody turns up fancy the rest, they get a free cocktail. If not, then they'll pay a fiver for a blood bag, and they look nice and bloody. It's Halloween.
Also on offer tonight will be a fresh batch of Karen's handmade British treats.
These are Scotch eggs, and I'm selling them tonight for €2 each, and all the money is going to dogs.
Well, it's all going on. Go on then, Karen, what's the secret to a Scottish Scotch egg?
Sausage meat and breadcrumbs, and I'm not telling you what I put in it. OK?
Trade secrets. Mum's the word. Clark's putting a lot of pressure on himself tonight, hoping their first Halloween bingo night at the bigger bar gets a full house. Luckily, it's a case of opposites attract.
Playing Disney stress, it's me it's stressing. I'm the one that stresses. Am I going to have two people sitting here playing bingo together, or am I going to have 26 people playing?
Are you going soon? Because I've got them people coming in.
Yeah, who's coming in?
There's 9 of them, I think, today.
Oh, well, that's super. So I suppose you better get going and get things going.
If you get out my way...
Okay, I'll get out your way. Like, my wife's maybe sharp and starcher, which is violent in nature.
I'm not. I'm a nice lady.
You're a nice lady, darling. I'll just stand over here.
If you're hoping Karen's going to help in the bar tonight, you better keep on her good side, Clark.
I think it'll be OK. Worries about nothing. I think it all turns out all right. Yeah, I think it'll be fine.
While Karen serves her last customers of the day...
OK, I'll just get the rest of your veg, OK?
Clark's back to the bar and bracing himself for the horrors that could lie ahead.
So I'm on the drink tonight. Well, I'm not on the drink tonight, but I'll be working on the drink tonight. I'm exhausted already.
Grab a cup of Clark. Speaking of which... On the Costa del Sol, Tea Lover Matt and Peter made the journey to the mountains to harvest the first batch of honey from their bees.
No. That's a bit too solid, that is.
The old track leading to the remote plot the pair bought a few months ago is studded with natural stone.
You're going to have to go more that side.
Matt usually visits the bees every week, but has left his new colony to settle for 2 weeks after their recent move to the hillside.
Beekeeping. It's called beekeeping for a reason and not bee leaving. So as long as every Saturday we manage all the hives, we know they're fine.
You got everything?
Yeah, I'll get the people after.
To safely get close to the hives, beekeepers often use smoke to subdue the bees. And Matt has a top tip for a free fuel to burn.
We found some fresh boar dung, so there's boars still running around at night. But for the bee smoker, it's the best stuff. But it's a little bit damp, so we need to leave it in the sun for a bit.
Wild boar are common across the Costa del Sol. Not everyone loves them, but at least they're leaving something useful.
Everything that basically grazes on grass, their dry manure, packed into a smoker, will last all afternoon. And it's widely available. It's free. Bargain.
That's one bargain I might have to pass on, but thanks, Matt. Until recently, Matt was selling honey harvested from another bee farm, but he's now aiming to make a living exclusively from his own hives.
We're just starting to supply shops, one in Gibraltar, a couple here on the coast in Spain, with our products. I'm hoping to get into a larger supermarket here on the coast. Then we can expand the company and go bigger and better. Quite a mission, actually, it was getting there, because some of the hives weighed 40, 50 kilos. Once we're at commercial level and we've got 100 hives, that's when we're going to be having to stay there the weekend and spend the whole weekend going through the bees. So at the minute, it's quite manageable.
Today's harvest is the first step in Matt's honey empire, but, oh, hang on, all's not well at the hives.
One of them is either swarming or being robbed.
Oh, really? Oof. Oh, no.
Looks, they're all out.
It seems the hives are under attack from other bees.
Either the other hives are robbing it, or ants have got in.
When bees are struggling to make honey, they may rob other weaker hives of their supplies.
Yeah, there's a lot of wax on the entrance.
Yeah, so that's robbing.
The attacking bees often injure and kill the hive they're burgling, and that would spell disaster for Matt's new business.
There's a bit of a call of emergency, so we can work out exactly what's happening.
On with the protective gear.
You'll be right. It's the crazy hive that's the one to watch for.
With the hive under attack, the bees are likely to be more aggressive. Quick, fire up that boar dung.
First sting.
Oof, careful, Matt.
What ones are doing the robbing?
It's a good question.
Matt and Peter need to work out where the bees robbing the hive are from and stop them quickly.
Yeah, there is a fight going on. Oh, a big fight. They are still resisting. We have three hives being robbed. But by what?
It's worse than they thought. Three of their eight hives are under siege. Matt and Peter need to act fast, or their new business could be over before it's begun.
We could potentially lose all the bees if we just don't get on top of the robbing here.
Coming up...
Wow.
An eerie transformation for Wayne and Lisa.
You need some white on your face, and then we'll just chuck some blood.
And a frightening monster attacks Matt...
Look, is it just trying to sting on my glove? Ooh.
..in the battle to save his ailing hives.
They produce very, very painful venom.
In the mountains above Minerva...
I need to block the entrance up and minimise it.
..there's a turf war raging at beekeepers Matt and Peter's brand-new honey farm.
So if I can put a strip across and tape it in place and leave a tiny hole for one bee to get in and out, then we can stop the robbing going on.
Three of their eight hives are being attacked by rogue bees. They're stealing Matt's honey and attacking his colony.
We need to actually get smoke on all of these bees to try and dissipate them.
It's costing Matt valuable honey and killing off his bees. If he can't sort it, his business could be finished.
We've blocked up the hive that we think's doing the robbing.
The boys had expected to harvest up to 40 kilos of honey today, equal to 80 jars, worth around 600 euros.
You see a lot of dead bees?
But if they don't stop the robbers quickly, there'll be no honey left to harvest, no bees left to make more, and no cash return on Matt's investment.
Because we don't have any dry manure, we've got to use anything we can that's going to create smoke. Desperately need manure.
You can never find dried pig poo when you need it.
There's nothing dry. If they are from that hive, I should see, once I get rid of them here, I should see a load of them over there trying to get in.
It's like watching Poirot.
I mean, we're not 100% sure it's our own bees. We suspect it is, but we don't know. Last year it happened that we weren't there and we lost all the hives. All of them.
It's a blow to Matt's new business. He was hoping to start making money today, but it's looking unlikely now. It's a stark reminder of how fragile each colony can be. Ha! Bee! Oh, bee. No, sorry, now's not the time.
It seemed to have calmed down. We're keeping the hive closed and moving it over there. I'm more worried about finding all the bees being killed.
To keep the remaining bees safe, the boys have moved the worst hit hive away from the attackers.
They're foraging for any last scraps that are there. Because when bees go robbing like this is when they're starving and they've got nothing in their hives. Well, all our hives have got honey in.
As all Matt's hives did have honey, the bee detective thinks the buzzing burglars might not be coming from his own hives.
I don't think there are any of our bees left in this one.
And as an emergency thing, what we can do is take the queen, whatever bees left, and put them in these little tiny boxes and start them off. As a drastic measure, so we can just save them.
It's not ideal, but rebuilding the hive gives the queen and her surviving subjects the chance to start producing honey again in peace. And one survivor is determined to say thank you.
It may have been one of the ones getting attacked because it's sort of pretty docile, with no energy, it's not really doing much. It'll only sting you if you squash it, if you trap it, or you open up their hive. See if I can stroke its wings.
Wow. Don't try this at home, folks. Matt's been working with bees for years.
I know a lot of people don't think they're important, but they're really important. Obviously, keeping bees, you get fond of them. They're lovely little creatures.
Once this little one flies off, the boys will need to open and rescue what's left of their hives.
Have you got some tape?
In Torremolinos, it's almost as scary. Wayne and Lisa's plans to throw their very first Halloween party are starting to take shape.
This is going to be the hand.
Party mad Wayne's desperate for the spooky celebrations to be a success.
Good job I'm creative, isn't it? It's looking pretty rubbish, to be honest with you. Can you buy hands from the shop?
On the guest list tonight is new chum Paul. They met at one of Wayne's gigs and he's invited his entire family tonight, all 15 of them.
We met so many lovely people, it really is good. That's why I invited them, because I thought, let them come along. And there's your four brains. The eyes, the stomach, and the hand.
Friends old and new are in for a messy night if this game's anything to go by.
They put their arm in, and they got the goo on their hand.
Time's ticking. Shouldn't you both be getting dressed?
It's me.
That's all right. But you need to have the white. You need some white on your face, and then we'll just chuck some blood around here and stuff. I got the oopong on.
Poor Freddy isn't sure about any of this. But Wayne's much-repaired vampire costume is looking pretty good.
Think of preferring without hair.
And on that note, time to go.
Just me and you in fancy dress. Now that would be a nightmare, wouldn't it?
Fear not, Wayne. Outside the restaurant, there's another suitably ghoulish couple.
Yo, bro.
We thought for sure you were going to prank us and we were going to be the only ones.
Oh, it's your mates, Phil and Peggy. You're all looking awful, as you should. It's Halloween.
We're here, we've landed. Let's go and have some fun.
If everyone's as excited as you are, Wayne, you'll have a frighteningly good night. One thing ghosts, ghouls and vampires aren't so keen on is sunshine. And unfortunately for them, not the rest of us, there's quite a lot of that about on the costas.
It's boiling here, absolutely scorching.
Oh, brilliant. That's the reason we're here.
What
could
amazing. You not like about the sun? It's fantastic,
yes.
It really is.
Gotcha.
You get your kit off and let the sun turn you brown.
You open the curtains here and just seeing the sky, that big ball of sun.
When you got that up there, everybody's happy, isn't that? It's our secret. Don't tell anybody.
Sorry, mate. Too late for that.
So it's all calmed down.
Thank God.
In the Costa del Sol Mountains...
Oh, I've got it.
Yes.
Good.
Matt and Peter's very first honey collection at their mountainside hives has gone to pot after a brutal bee robbery.
Oh, look, is it just trying to sting on my glove? Oh, that was lucky, wasn't it?
And now there's another predator making their presence felt.
They're called Oriental hornets. They produce very, very painful venom. You don't want to get stung by one of these. I've only noticed these in the last couple of years here in Spain, and now they're everywhere.
These aggressive stingers will also attack hives to eat the bees. It's like the blooming Wild West. Who knew beekeeping would be so much bother? Now they need to see if there are any survivors to help save their business.
You see, there are barely any bees left. Okay, let's start pulling out the frames.
It's cost Matt around 500 euros for this setup of 8 hives. Money his new business can't afford to lose if the colonies don't even survive their first few weeks in the new location.
Yeah, this one here.
And the attack today has been a huge blow.
Yeah, look, there's a load of dead bees at the bottom. That's definitely got more honey in it. That's it then, this is a write-off now then.
Mm-hmm.
But all is not lost.
This one has been reduced to a very small number because there have been attacks. So we've just minimised them and got them into a smaller box.
I doubt it's been honey today because of all this, what's happened, it's thrown everything out.
Yeah, they've got honey here.
They look like strong numbers.
Yeah, this is a strong hive. Lots of honey.
Finally, some honey. There's enough to leave some for the bees and take some back to spin and jar.
Sorted out all of them. So we need to come back, do these tomorrow and check on the ones we've done.
It may be less than they'd hoped, but today's honey haul is still heavy.
A few kilos in this. Have you noticed? No robin on that wooden hive. It's been nice and calm on the entrance all day.
We'll come back tomorrow.
We'll have to come back tomorrow, and if we work out that it is that wooden one, we're going to have to move that wooden one away and take it away. Mm. Probably put it at the bottom of my garden.
Yeah.
Detective Matt may have just solved the case. Today has stung. It's not the start Matt and Peter wanted for their business, but they are heading home with something sweet.
This is full of honey. It's probably 10 kilos of honey in there.
Well, 10 kilos is still 20 jars of honey. 140 euros won't quite cover the setup costs, but it's a start.
Sometimes nothing happens with the bees, and then sometimes hell breaks loose, and you've just got to drop everything and deal with the issue. But the good thing about it is that we managed to catch it, and it didn't go unchecked, you know, because that would have been a complete disaster. Yeah, another day, new stuff to deal with. Every day is something different.
All that's left today is making a beeline for home. Job well done, Matt.
If somebody's been in cleaning and moving stuff, then we've got our normal bingo books.
In Benidorm, Clark's hoping for every one of his 36 seats to be filled at tonight's ghoulish premiere of Halloween Bingo.
I think it's going to go very well. I was only expecting 10 initially. I'm looking at 20 plus. Maybe even more. Maybe we'll go for capacity at 36. I've never ever done this before, and thankfully, the software that we invested in actually has integrated voice, so it does all the bingo calls for me. All I have to do is click start and click pause when somebody shouts house.
It's like the rise of the machines. Let's just hope it works. More reliable is Clark's wife of 20 years, Karen.
No, I'll come and help if I have to, but I want to play bingo. I've worked for hours, I don't need to go to the bar and work as well.
I said reliable, not keen. But with Clark, a man short behind the bar tonight, you might not have a choice.
People are starting to appear. I know that there are plenty of other people coming. Check these tickets, just make sure that every book is exactly the same. The colours have to match. Each ticket has to match for everybody to make it fair. We might end up with multiple winners, and the prize money will be next to nothing. And I won't be very popular with my customers.
Ooh, iron brew.
I'm Scottish.
Do you have any bingo dabbers?
Ooh, someone's keen.
No, we've only got felt-tip pens, but that's what they use in the Spanish bingo anyway. You don't get dabbers in Spanish bingo.
Playing Spanish rules tonight, folks, and here come more of tonight's players.
Yeah, it's getting busier. Starting to fill up. Knew it would. Starting off with it. It's getting there. Happy bunny.
It's a good turnout. Only a few seats spare, but no one's embraced the spooky season and come in costume. Come on, Karen. Time to show willing.
The clerk had a spare one. It's a convict. But I don't know if it'll fit me or not, because it's large, so it might be a bit long. Give it a try anyway.
Well, we've got a couple in, so, yeah, I can't see much of the regular locals being fancy dressed, but it is what it is.
What's your costume then, Clark?
I'm not going zombie bear. I bought the costume. I'm not wearing the mask. I got a better one. This one. Yeah, good. I can light it up. That's a better one. That's a scary bear.
You don't see many of those in the old town.
I Hello. I look like a sack of ties. Well, it's getting busy, so I need to go and start speaking to people and see if there's any jobs I need to do.
And you, if you do that again, you go to prison.
Ta-da! Ah! Hello, people.
Well, Bungle's seen better days.
Oh, I have to take this off. The sweat's rolling off my face. Oh, my God, the heat. We'll start selling tickets shortly, and then we'll get fired in, and then we'll get started that and see how everything goes. I think it'll be a promising night, yeah.
He's hoping it will be a full house in high spirits. Coming up...
Please be quiet. They're trying to play bingo.
Yeah.
Be afraid anyone who interrupts Clark and Karen's Halloween jackpot.
Eyes down for your first line.
And what's a little blood between friends at Halloween?
Put it all over the place. Ready to go.
The bingo is available. Come and buy your books.
Yes, you will.
Clark and Karen's Halloween bingo night is kicking off enthusiastically.
€10. Well, if... Yeah. Wait till I get some change. There we go.
No, I need 2 pence.
Oh, OK.
With almost every one of the 36 seats taken, Clark is feeling generous and is happy for Karen to take the night off and enjoy the game.
We'll do a couple of games and then we'll start selling the raffles.
OK, lovely. Thank you very much.
Hello, my darling.
Me, Paul and Tony, love.
So, €30, please.
Looks like everyone's up for Halloween bingo. With 5 games at €2 apiece, it's a good value night out for the customers.
The money that comes in from the bingo just stays in the bingo. That gets paid out as prize money. Stay 80, 100, 120 so far. Probably some more coming.
Can't wait.
Ready.
Can't wait.
Yay! It's fun, man.
Feeling lucky, lads? Well, that's more Mystic Meg than Halloween, but OK.
It's the first time we've done it, so we'll see. Hopefully no technical glitches.
More used to calling the numbers himself, Clark's invested in some software, which will do the calling for him. As yet untested, it's time to fire it up and get playing.
Fingers crossed it all runs and it works perfectly. I think it will.
What's that you're drinking, Helen?
A blood bag.
The spooky cocktails may be going down a storm.
It's not bad.
Getting into the spirit of it, but the Pack Bar have come for one thing and one thing alone, and they take it very seriously.
Right.
Can you please be quiet? They're trying to play bingo.
Yeah. I'm scared. Now it feels like Halloween.
Eyes down for your first line.
4 and 6, 46. All the 7s, 77.
Definitely. Yeah, I'm happy with it. Seven, we'll see what happens 70. When I push pause.
5 and 3, 53.
Bingo.
One house called. Can we have a check out?
Sorry, Karen. Looks like you're still on the clock.
Correct.
66.
Correct.
74.
Correct. One house correct. Hey. You've won 15 bananas. There was a line. We'll continue now for a full house. And your next number.
4 and 0, blind 40.
Oh, it's tense, isn't it?
22.
22. Bingo!
Ooh, another winner. Blimey, that was quick. But tonight, Clark's winning. The new pub's packed with paying customers.
Yeah.
And another winner.
We have a bogey. 66 is not being called.
Yeah. Eyes down once again.
All the sixes. Yeah. 66.
Well, we all heard it that time, and it's not just the winner smiling. They seem to love it.
It's been a great night. Great success. Bingo went well. The automated bingo system works well. We'll be doing it again on Wednesday. The secret to success here is having the right people spending the right amount of money and enjoying themselves.
If it ain't broke, eh, Clark? Tonight has been a scarily good success.
Yeah. We've got a winner here.
Okay. I like your outfits. You're looking good.
Speaking of scary, there's a terrifying turnout at Wayne and Lisa's first ever Halloween party in Torremolinos.
That's your suit, it, don't you? Yeah.
Elsa's here.
And you're looking spooktacular, Elsa.
I'm going to go put some white stuff on my face.
As it's his favourite celebration, Wayne's out to ensure his Halloween efforts leave a lasting impression.
Okay, give us that little mirror then and then I can see.
But the finishing touches to the vampire outfit are streakier than bacon, mate.
Let's get it on.
Much better.
It'll look all right when I put some blood on it. It's all over my hands, I have to wash it all off.
And all over the floor.
Yeah, I mean that.
And all over the side.
Well, I'm scared of you, Wayne.
I've got it all over the place. I'm covered in blood. Looks like it's not even coming out. Looks like I'm stuck with it for the rest of that on my hands.
No time to hang about.
Ready to go.
The guest of honour, Wayne's new mate Paul, and his family are here.
Is this near that Billy's bar where you told us to get that?
Yeah. Billy's is just across there.
It's on the side, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, you could have dressed up, Paul.
So people don't catch on to what we're doing. Be quick about it.
But Wayne can't chat. He needs to get the spooky party game started.
And then give me some honey as well. So the everything's got to be gooey. This is disgusting. So I reckon we just say, like, 1 point for the eye, 2 points for the
belly.
No,
the I would just say that's what's right.
OK, then.
Maybe you should have decided your rules of play before now, Wayne, but, well, let's crack on with contestants Bianca and Phil. Identify the body parts, cauliflower and grapes, to you and me in the box. Bianca's up first.
OK, what is that?
Fingers!
Come on, Phil, your go.
Oh! What is that?
That is the brain.
No, it's wrong.
It's a melon, mate. Well, as it's a party, best of five?
He's right.
Oh!
It's disgusting inside here now.
It's the guts.
He's got the guts.
Definitely need guts to put your hand in there.
Tiebreaker. What do we do?
I know what we do.
OK.
They win my pumpkin.
Works for me.
Woo! Thank you so much.
No clear winner on the game, but Wayne and Lisa have chalked up a successful first stab at a Spanish Halloween party. Everyone's having a blast.
And I'm going to have nightmares.
We've had a good laugh, and some of the people have come in fancy dress and they look really good.
They look better than us, aren't they?
Yeah, better than us. Yeah, nice seeing some new people with us.
Yeah.
But it's good to spend time with our friends. The party's just beginning.
Happy Halloween, everybody.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween!